A law affecting the relationship between police and those suffering from mental health disorders goes into effect this Sunday. And while advocates say it makes people safer, law enforcement officers are worried it limits their power.
Rania Kaur spoke to behavioral health experts on exactly what these changes are and what you need to know.
This new law outlines how much force can be used and when, but with only three instances clearly outlined, healthcare providers say only time will tell what this will look like actually implemented. Those three circumstances are when police have probable cause a crime has been committed, someone is escaping a crime scene, or there is a threat of imminent danger. Daniel Fox, clinical supervisor for Passages, says there are times when law enforcement needs to use force.
Sometimes there's a gray area where that individual is not going to agree to go and get mental health support on their own. And so sometimes they need to be, you know, helped to do that. And this new law is going to kind of take away those moments when that person may be forced to get some help.
The gray areas are exactly why Dr. Kamaljeet Flora with Inland Northwest Behavioral Health wants the law more clearly defined.
This bill, 1310. It's well intended, but it is in its baby stage. It needs more interpretation and clarification.
A part of this bill says when someone is in a mental health crisis, police need to call in a mental professional if possible already. Spokane Police Department has been implementing this in the behavioral health unit.
It is always a struggle because the person who is in crisis, he does not want help, but we want to give the help and he needs the help, but still, how to provide that help is the question.
These health professionals also worry about the person who calls 911 to begin with.
Sometimes what happens is that person seems okay, they go right back in, they haven't gotten any treatment because they refuse treatment. And then what happens is it escalates and somebody in the home gets hurt.
I'm Rania Kaur for News Now.